assigning values, renaming game objects, aligning objects. How much valuable time do you waste with tasks that could just as well be done by a monkey? Well, no more. Batch Processor will do all of this for you from now on, so your venerable brain will be free to work on the important stuff. Batch Processor is all about making your life easier. It provides sophisticated ways of finding game objects across all open scenes, and then lets you process those in all sorts of ways. Let's look at an example. What if we want to make sure that these 50 columns all have colliders? We want to name and number them properly and arrange them in a perfect circle. Previously, that was a very tedious job, but with Batch Processor, it's quick and easy. First, we need to find all game objects that have a name that contains col. Yes, now we've found all 50 columns. Then we say add remove component, drag and drop a box collider in there, click on execute, and now all of them have a box collider. Now we want to rename all of them. How about we name the small ones differently than the big ones? We search for everything that has col in the name and that has a collider size where y is smaller than 1. And this gives us only the small columns. We use an assign interval processor on the game object name. We set it to assign, set the prefix to column stump, start with a value of 1 and use an interval of 1 as well. And now the small ones are all named and numbered. For the big ones, we do it the other way around and search for colliders that have a y bigger than 1. We set the prefix to column, use a starting value of 1 and again an interval of 1. And now all the big ones are named and numbered as well. To arrange all the columns in a circle, we simply search for all the columns again and use a processor called PositionArrange. This gives us some nice gizmos in a scene view where we can interactively set up our circle. And it gives you a good idea that a processor can really do pretty much anything. If we press execute, everything jumps into place. But I think we should make it look at the center. Yes, much nicer, but I don't like how the big ones and the small ones are grouped together, so let's sort by random factor and execute again. Very nice. Now this was a very simple example, but Batch Processor is quite powerful. It supports all sorts of fields on any kind of script. And since Batch Processor uses reflection, it will simply work with all new scripts that you write. And you know what? This is just a start. We'll add more features and functionality as we work on our own projects and run into useful things. And so can you. Batch Processor is highly customizable, so you can write your own processors and make it do the most custom stuff ever. We even added a special option to the Create menu that will create a new processor script for you, ready to be filled with your custom goodness. Sounds good? Well then, give it a try and see how much time Batch Processor can save you.